Guys, welcome back to the channel. It's been a long time I haven't uploaded a video, and I'd like to thank each and every one of you very much. It's been a long time I didn't upload a video, but still you guys have been showing a wonderful support. I'm really thankful for that. And okay, I'm starting back. I'm trying to upload as many as videos possible from now on. So for today, let's start off with antiepileptics. So for that purpose, we need to understand, as usual, what is epilepsy. Epilepsy is a condition associated with something called seizure. So epilepsy is a disease associated with what? Seizure. Now we need to understand what is seizure. Yes or no? So when we need to understand what is seizure, very simple thing. We have brain. In our brain, we have neurons. Neurons are doing what? The neurons are responsible for the conduction of the signal from brain to the rest of the body for the function. Now, very simple, understand. A part of my brain, for example, let's keep, which is responsible for the movement of my upper arm. Now, what happens? All of a sudden, it starts to send lot of signals. And my upper arm loses control and does some involuntary activity, so which is not under my control. Now a part of brain, what it is doing? A part of brain which is discharging the signals abnormally and uncontrolled, that is leading to a seizure. That's called seizure. Okay, now seizure will lead to epilepsy. Now epilepsy is a condition. What we need to do is, epilepsy people, they will have recurrent episodes of seizure, means they will have a repeated attacks of the seizure. Our target during the epilepsy treatment is prevent the attack of the seizure. So this is a simplified meaning. Okay, now when we get into the types, which is a drug of choice, which type of epilepsy, what to do, what not to do, there is lot of things which we should go through in the perspective of internal medicine. But let's go through in a pharma point of view, what are the drugs we need to learn. So when we need to understand that, let's understand. We understood seizure, we understood what is epilepsy. Now we need to understand types of seizures. Types of seizures is not so important while learning the drugs, but it's very simple. Seizures are classified into simple and complex seizures, or partial complex seizure. Complex seizure include tonic-clonic, myoclonic. So we have multiple types of seizure. I'm not going into that detail, but let's get into the drugs directly. So if you want to get into the drugs, we need to know what? We need to know how exactly neurotransmission occurs. When we need to know how exactly neurotransmission occurs, let's draw a neuron. We have a neuron here. Okay. Now we have our second neuron sitting over here. So this will be our synapse, presynaptic membrane, postsynaptic membrane. We know all this data. Let's start what happens. Whenever I stimulate my neuron, whenever my neuron gets stimulated, it will allow the sodium ions to come in. So that's how a signal starts. That signal will start to propagate along with the membrane, and it will come near where? It will come near the presynaptic membrane. When it comes near the presynaptic membrane, we have voltage-gated calcium channels, right? Now voltage-gated calcium channels will get excited and get opened up. That will allow calcium ion to flow inside the neuron. When calcium ion flow inside the neuron, let's leave it here for a moment and let's see something. We have something called synaptic vesicles, which are sitting here, right? Now synaptic vesicle contains what? Neurotransmitter. Yes or no? So we have synaptic vesicle and neurotransmitter. Now in central nervous system, we can have neurotransmitter which cause the excitation or inhibition. Now we can have what type of neurotransmitter? It could be inhibitory neurotransmitter, or it could be excitatory neurotransmitter. Now we are talking about the signal propagation of the excitation. So let's see which is the excitatory neurotransmitter. That is our glutamate. Now what happened? Calcium came in, it causes exocytosis of the vesicle, allowing the glutamate to come into the synaptic cleft. Now glutamate is in the synaptic cleft. When it comes into the synaptic cleft, it will work on what? It will work on the receptor responsible for glutamate. So what are those receptors for glutamate? The receptor for glutamate are AMPA and NMDA. What is that? NMDA. What is that? AMPA and NMDA. Now very simple thing, you don't have to get confused. AMPA is a simple sodium channel. Whenever glutamate acts on that, it will get opened up, allow the sodium ions to come in. Now what is NMDA? NMDA is a calcium channel. Whenever glutamate act on NMDA receptor, it will allow the calcium ion to come. Now what happens when calcium ion comes into our neuron? Very simple thing. Our neuron will get excited. When neuron gets excited, what happens? When neuron gets excited, signal will propagate. And what will happen? We have our signal, we have our whatever the purpose, for example, it might be motor activity of the upper arm, lower arm, any part of the body, okay? So this our signal is being propagated. When these sodium ions come inside, they will allow little calcium ions to come inside from this part as well, okay? So this is how a signal is being propagated. Now I told in the start of our video, what was that? Whenever we have uncontrolled abnormal discharge of the neuron, it will cause seizure, I told, right? Now this is present in every single person, like normal people like me and you. So why we don't have seizure? Because we have a mechanism which is, we discussed excitatory mechanism, but we are left with inhibitory. So we have an inhibitory mechanism. What it does, let's see. Inhibitory mechanism is something like a brake which holds the excitatory system. So now excitatory and inhibitory has to work in a balance, and only then what we have? A balanced neuronal activity. Let's take one more neuron here. Okay, now this inhibitory neurotransmitter, what is this? Inhibitory neurotransmitter is our GABA. What is that? GABA. What is GABA? Gamma amino butyric acid. Now when we are talking about gamma amino butyric acid, what happens? Whenever I have a signal which will come into the GABA receptor, same story, calcium, sodium comes in, open the calcium channels, calcium ion comes in. Here we have our GABA vesicle. In the vesicle we have GABA neurotransmitter sitting. Only difference between here and there, that is glutamate was what? Glutamate was an excitatory neurotransmitter, GABA is a inhibitory neurotransmitter. Now what happens whenever the signal comes, whenever exocytosis of the GABA happens, GABA will come out and it will work on the GABA receptor. It will work on the GABA receptor. We have our GABA receptor sitting here. Okay, now GABA came, it acted on the GABA receptor. GABA receptor is a very simple thing, it's a sort of chloride ion channel. What it will do, it will allow the chloride ion to go inside. Chloride ion is a negatively charged ion, it is going from outside to inside of the cell. That will lead to what? Hyperpolarization of the cell. When there is a hyperpolarization of the cell, what happens to the cell? Is it easy for the cells to get excited or difficult for the cell to get excited? That will be difficult for the cell to get excited. Okay, so this is a story how a brake works, brake system, that is our GABA system works, and how our excitatory system works. So we are clear with the normal physiology of the neurotransmission. Now let's see antiepileptics. Antiepileptics, we know already definition, that is abnormal uncontrolled neuronal discharge. So it is something like we have GABA on one side, we have glutamate on one side. Either GABA goes down, that might lead to a seizure, or for example glutamate itself, GABA will be normal, glutamate will go up, that might lead to seizure. So let's treat these people by stimulating GABA or by inhibiting the glutamate pathway. Let's see what happens. Now we have our GABA. In GABA system, we have two groups of drugs which works here. That is our benzodiazepines and barbiturates. Now what I am trying to do here is benzodiazepines and barbiturates. These are the drugs which will act on the GABA receptor. They will make GABA channel open and allow the chloride ions to flow in and cause the hyperpolarization. But let's understand the basic mechanism and let's leave it here, because I want to make a separate video for the benzodiazepine and barbiturates. We have benzodiazepines like nitrazepam, we have diazepam, we have midazolam, we have benzodiazepine, we have barbiturates like phenytoin, we have, for example, barbituric acid. Okay, now let's not talk about those things because I want to make a separate video on them. Now we have GABA. Whatever GABA is released, GABA will be reuptaken by GABA 1 transporter. Sorry, that is gamma amino butyric acid transporter 1. What is that? Gamma amino butyric acid transporter 1. Now what I have to do? Seizure was what? Seizure was a condition where I had excitatory neurotransmission was going high. For that GABA was a brake. Now if I inhibit GAT, I don't have GAT, what will happen? GABA will remain in the synaptic cleft. GABA is more chloride ion flowing in, more of hyperpolarization. Now I can treat the epilepsy by doing what? By giving a GAT1 inhibitor that includes our T-GABA. What is tigabine? Pay attention. Tigabine is our GAT1 inhibitor. What is GAT1 inhibitor? GAT1 inhibitor is a transporter. GAT1 is a transporter. When we inhibit this transport, what will happen? GABA will be increased in the synaptic cleft. Okay. So, this is about our GABA system. Okay. So, we are done with the GABA system. Now, let's go into our glutamate. So here we have our sodium channels, we have our calcium channels, we have sodium and calcium channel. So everything is majorly based on what? Everything is majorly based on our calcium channels and sodium channel. Let's see how to do the treatment for epilepsy based on this. Very simple thing. Let's inhibit the sodium channel. Now sodium channel blockers. Sodium channel blockers include carbamazepine. We have oxcarbazepine, then we have, for example, sodium valproate, that is valproic acid. We have one more drug called as zonisamide. And we have one more drug called as topiramate. And we have our phenytoin also inhibit our sodium channel. Now we have carbamazepine, oxcarbazepine, valproic acid, zonisamide, topiramate, phenytoin. There are multiple other drugs as well. Now let's pay attention. One simple thing is what they were doing, all of these people, they were inhibiting the sodium channel. No sodium channel, no propagation, no release of our glutamate into the synaptic cleft. No synaptic cleft glutamate, no excitation for the progression. There is no epilepsy. Now there is no rule that all of these drugs just inhibit the sodium channel, but our valproate and zonisamide, they also inhibit the calcium channel. Which are these calcium channels? They are the T-type calcium channel. What they are doing, they are inhibiting the calcium ion entry so that no excitation and there is no further propagation of our signal. Okay, so we are done with this thing. Now let's see one simple thing. We have some drugs which inhibit NMDA receptor. Okay, and one thing I wanted to talk here very importantly is levetiracetam. What is that? The drug name is called as levetiracetam. Levetiracetam is a drug. What happens is, we have our synaptic vesicle. Vesicle was filled with what? Vesicle was filled with our glutamate. What happens is, there is some special protein sitting on the vesicle that will go and inhibit that protein and do not allow the synaptic vesicle to break. So if when synaptic vesicle do not break, there is no glutamate and there is no further progression of the signal. So levetiracetam is very good drug for the prophylaxis. Now almost every drug whatever we are using is for the prophylaxis only. Okay, so this is about our anti-epileptic drugs. So when we want to see, the last thing I wanted to tell is NMDA blocker. That is, we have one drug called as felbinate. What is it called as? Felbinate. Felbinate is a drug which inhibits our NMDA receptor. So NMDA blocker is felbinate. Now we are done with all the important drugs for the epilepsy treatment. But I want to talk more, little more about valproic acid and finish our video. So let's see little bit about valproic acid. And almost all anti-epileptic drugs can be taken orally, and levetiracetam is used intravenously as well. So for the purposes, for example, when the patient is having stroke, we suspect patient might get the seizure, then we prefer to give intravenous administration of levetiracetam. That is a good choice. But I wanted to talk about valproic acid. Now valproic acid, we already spoke, what is that? Valproic acid is a drug which blocks sodium channels as well as T-type calcium channels. Now both of them are being blocked by the valproic acid, but I wanted to talk a little bit about the side effects. Now what happens, side effect of the valproic acid is little important. The only reason is definitely it will cause sleepiness and all those things, but I want to talk about weight gain. It might predispose a patient to the PCOD. Then it might even cause acute pancreatitis and hyperammonemia. It might cause what? Acute pancreatitis and hyperammonemia. Apart from that, this drug even causes nausea, vomiting. Definitely, almost in pharma it has been very simple thing. Most of the students, what we tend to do is we tend to say, what are the side effects? Yeah, just say that vomiting and nausea. Yeah, I agree with that, we can say. But let's try to remember few important drugs, few important side effects of a drug. And remember one thing, please do not give this valproic acid to a pregnant woman. The only reason was because that will cause neural tube defect. What is neural tube? Neural tube is an embryogenic structure which is responsible for the development of the brain and the spinal cord. So that is why do not use it in a pregnant woman. If you use it in a pregnant woman, the baby will have, for example, the associated diseases with the development of the brain. Okay, now we have valproic acid. Why I was stressing on the valproic acid? The only reason is valproic acid can be used in almost all possible types of seizures. So that's why I was stressing a little bit more on the valproic acid. So we're done with the valproic acid, and let's see a little very simple thing. I wanted to talk about febrile seizure. Febrile seizure, well, I don't want to write anything or any further explanation, but I want to say the thing is, febrile seizure is seen with the infants. What happens is, when there is an elevation of the body temperature, that will cause the seizure. Now here antiepileptics are not the drug of choice, but our target is to decrease the fever in the child, maintain the body temperature, then further proceeding is the one. And one more condition I wanted to speak here is eclampsia. Eclampsia is a condition when pregnant woman has hypertension as along with the seizure. Now preeclampsia was there, that preeclampsia progressed into eclampsia causing the seizures. That time we do not prefer any sort of antiepileptics, but we tend to prefer what? We tend to prefer magnesium sulfate. Magnesium sulfate is a drug of choice which could be used during the epilepsy associated with the eclampsia. Now during eclampsia, what we have is hypertension. Along with hypertension, there could be epilepsy, there could be, for example, condition associated with proteinuria. So this is about our antiepileptic drugs. Now antiepileptic drugs, most important thing, what, where we need to pay attention, what I feel is, pay attention towards the mechanism. You can understand everything based on our nerve conduction and impulse conduction. If you know that much, you can put, you just need to little bit go through the names, and that's it. Thank you very much guys, keep following.